Hi friends, in this video we are going to discuss about Indian politics related questions. These questions will be very helpful in all the competitive exams. So now we will see the questions along with the answers in detail.
First question, part 4 of Indian Constitution deals with which of the following? Options: Union Executive, Citizenship, Fundamental Rights, Directive Principles of State Policy. Right answer is option 4, Directive Principles of State Policy. Next, consider the following two statements regarding the implementation of anti-defection law. First statement, if an elected member voluntarily gives up his membership of a political party. Option 2, if an elected member votes or abstains from voting in such house contrary to any direction issued by his political party or anyone authorized to do so without obtaining any prior permission, which of the above two statements is a criteria for the anti-defection law? Options, neither one nor two. Option 2, only two. Option 3, only one. Option 4, both one and two. And the right answer is option 4, both one and two. Next, what is the tenure of the office of Comptroller and Auditor General of India? Options, 5 years or age of 60, whichever is lower. Option 2, age of 60. Option 3, 4 years or age of 65, whichever is lower. Option 4, 6 years or age of 65, whichever is lower. Correct answer is option 4, 6 years or the age of 65, whichever is lower. Next, who is the current CAG of India? Options, Rajiv Maharshi, Vinod Rai, Shashikant Sharma, B.N. Kaul. Correct answer is option 1, Rajiv Maharshi. Next, right to property according to the constitution is? Options, directive principles, fundamental right, legal right, social right. Answer is option 3, legal right. Next, consider the following statements. First statement, the anti-defection law gives for the first time a clear-cut constitutional recognition to the existence of political parties. Second statement, the total number of ministers including the Prime Minister in the Central Council of Ministers shall not exceed 15% of the total strength of the Lok Sabha. Article 16(4), which of the following statement given is correct? Options, neither one nor two. Option 2, both one and two. Option 3, two only. Option 4, one only. Right answer is option 4, only one, that is first statement is correct. Next, which is the highest and final judicial tribunal in respect of the Constitution of India? Options, Parliament, Supreme Court, Union Cabinet, President. Correct answer is option 2, Supreme Court. Next, in which city the Central Bureau of Investigation Academy located? Options, Mumbai, Ghaziabad, Darjeeling, New Delhi. Correct answer is option 2, Ghaziabad. Next, to whom the Speaker of the Lok Sabha gives his resignation? Options, Chief Justice of India, Deputy Speaker of Lok Sabha, Prime Minister, President. Correct answer is option 2, Deputy Speaker of Lok Sabha. Next, Constitution of India came into effect on? Options, 26 January 1950, 15 August 1950, 26 November 1949, 15th January 1950. Correct answer is option 1, 26th January 1950. Next. When was the anti-defection law was passed? Options 1950, 2005, 1985, 1960. Answer is option 3, 1985. Next. Which of the following corporations is fully audited by Controller and Auditor General of India? Options: State Bank of India, Air India, Life Insurance Corporation, Reserve Bank of India. Correct answer is option 2, Air India. Next. The total number of schedules in the Constitution are options 10, 14, 8, 12. Right answer is option 4, 12. Next. The Central Bureau of Investigation comes under the administrative control of options Ministry of Home Affairs, none of these, Ministry of Defense, Department of Personnel and Training of the Ministry of Personnel. Right answer is option 4, Department of Personnel and Training of the Ministry of Personnel. Next. Which committee suggested the exemption from disqualification in case of a split from 10th schedule? Options: Kelkar Committee, none of these, S.K. Majhi Committee, option 4, Dinesh Goswami Committee. Right answer is option 4, Dinesh Goswami Committee. Next. Consider the following two statements. First statement, the Central Bureau of Investigation is exempt from the right to information, Act 2. Second one, Central Bureau of Investigation is a part of union subject and not state or concurrent subjects. Which of the above is true? Options, neither one nor two. Option 2, only one. Option 3, both 1 and 2. Option 4, only 2. Right answer is option 3, both 1 and 2 statements are correct. Next. Who is the final deciding authority on the question of disqualification by anti-defection? Options, President, Prime Minister, none of these. Option 4, Chairman or Rajya Sabha or Speaker of Lok Sabha. Right answer is option 4, Chairman or Rajya Sabha or Speaker of Lok Sabha. Next. In which year the Central Bureau of Investigation was established? Options, 1965, 1963, 1950, 1947. Right answer is option 2, 1963. Where are the headquarters of Central Bureau of Investigation located? Options, Mumbai, Darjeeling, Ghaziabad, New Delhi. Right answer is option 4, New Delhi. Last one. The Constitution of India was adopted by the Constituent Assembly on? Options, 25th October 1958, 26th January 1950, 26th January 1949, 26th November 1949. Right answer is option 3, 26th January 1949.
Thank you for watching this video. Please share and subscribe our channel for more videos.